Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I am thrilled to be able to bring to you another episode of Ask Dotto Tech, the show where you ask questions and I answer them. Now, you can ask me questions about anything related to technology, and if I can, I will answer them. We have a treat today because we are going to be talking about my favorite apps that I'm running on my iPhone. It's based on a request from you today on Ask Dotto Tech. This show is dedicated to helping you get more out of your technology by asking questions, and if I can, I answer them. And oh, you ask such good questions. Now, you can ask me questions anywhere. You can ask me questions here in the YouTube chat area. You can ask me them if you're a subscriber to our newsletter by just replying to the newsletter in Facebook, or you can even use that audio new social network Anchor, which some of our people are doing these days. But this question here came from Talenda, who said, "How the heck am I doing this beautiful day?" I'm doing great, Talenda, as I mentioned off the top of the show. "As sworn Android user, but you keep seeing me using iOS, and it's made him, her, not too sure, curious. So I went out and bought an iPad, an Air 2, thinking Steve uses it all the time, it can't be bad, and I'm like it already. But basically asking me to run down my favorite apps in iOS, and leaving out the obvious ones like Evernote that I use all the time. So I'm gonna spend a few minutes and show you some of my favorite apps. Now, these might not be long-term apps. These are the ones that I'm kind of caught up with right now and liking. But some of them I've been using for a very long time. So where to begin? I know where we'll begin. We'll begin right here with YouTube, because one of the things that I, as a YouTube content creator, need to constantly do is stay in touch with what's happening in my channel. And YouTube has an app available both Android and iOS called the YouTube Creator, the Studio app, which allows me to go in and to be able to view everything that's happening in my channel as though I was in the Creator Studio on the desktop. I can go in and I can see all the statistics for the watch time and the number of viewers that I've got, all of that sort of stuff for my videos. I can go in and I can look at details of any individual video just by tapping on it. Now, this isn't a viewing app. This is an app that allows us to manage the environment. So if I want to go in and see all of the analytics, just how this video is doing, I can see all of those sorts of things, how people are finding the video, where they're discovering it from. All of that information comes to me here within the Creator Studio and within the studio app, within the YouTube Creator Studio app. So this is something that I use all of the time when I'm out and running around. I find it incredibly useful. Now, I've been doing a lot more with Twitter these days. I've been trying to do a lot in Twitter, but with Twitter, my commitment is only kind of one directional. I like to publish content into Twitter. I don't necessarily want to engage too much in conversations on Twitter. But to help me publish more in Twitter, I'm using the Twitter Buffer app, which helps me go through, don't ask me again, I'm not going to share, sorry, which allows me to go through, and it allows me to find, if I take a look down here in the bottom of the content or in the analytics, let's start in the analytics, it tells me which of my posts that I've got buffered and that I'm sending out in buffer now. It tells me how well they're performing, and I can scroll through this very quickly just when I've got a few minutes and say, oh, this is a fairly popular post. It's had three shares. So what I do with that is I rebuffer these posts. The thing about Twitter, if you're curating content as I use it for, as I do, basically sending out additional content and basically using it to help people stay on top of all the things that I find interesting that they might find interesting. If you're using it that way, sending out a tweet once is next to useless. If you've got good content, you've got to send it out 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 20 times because of how fast the information goes by within Twitter. So Buffer is an app that I'm quite liking using, and it's one that does quite well for me as well, I think. Anyways, moving along to other tools. Well, you know, I can't not talk about Slack, because Slack is, for us, one of the most valuable tools that as far as communicating and managing my team. Why is it not working the way I want it to? Come on, Slack, you should slide. There it is. So this, I actually have four different teams that I work with: the people at Social Media Examiner, a Slack course, guys that I do a productivity blab with, and my own Dotto Tech community of all of the people that work with me on Dotto Tech, all here, and I communicate with them all in Slack. This is our unified messaging client for all things that we do. So Slack, to me, is a total winner. You know, I also am increasingly liking Google Photos, which I've talked about in the past, so I won't even bother opening that right now, but that's one that I like. But speaking of the imaging world, Adobe Post has kind of caught my attention. Adobe has released a graphics tool for social sharing, for social graphics, and it's really set up as an Instagram kind of tool. It's all square format, but it allows you to choose any of these very cool and very well Adobe-ish design templates that you can choose, add your own graphics, modify the text, change the colors. They do something called a remix. So if I wanted to take this and remix it, I actually don't like that one all that much, but I can quickly change the color. Maybe I like it better in those colors. So you see it changes the colors of the foreground. You change the photo, remix all this stuff using Adobe's good design characteristics along with your great content, and then you've got a social sharing graphic that you can be proud of. Adobe Post, be free. I like Adobe Post. And those of you that are in the deep end of the Adobe pool using their Adobe's, using all of their different studio tools, all of them available to access directly from within Adobe Post. So it's got some nice integration through to the rest of the whole Adobe design suite. Do I have anything else? No. Everything else I've kind of done demos on right now. So we'll do this from time to time. This was a good idea. Thank you very much, Talende. It was a good idea for me to share some of the less popular but very useful tools that I use on a regular basis. Now, there's three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. Second, I encourage you to subscribe to our newsletter. That way, I will be able to inform you about our free webinars, tutorials, trainings, and courses. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported by the generosity of you folks who watch the channel through the crowdfunding site Patreon. I would encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, have a look, and discover the perks that are included with supporting Dotto Tech. And those perks are a little bit of awesomeness. Till next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.